children to Standard 8, General Science, Chapter 5, Inside the Atom, Module 3. The learning objectives for this session are to understand the concept of valency, to learn how to calculate the valency of atoms, to study about isotopes and their importance, and to understand the importance of nuclear energy. Children, in the last chapter, we have seen that valency means the number of chemical bonds formed by an atom. We have also learned that generally, the valency of an element in its compound remains constant. In this GIF, you can see that sodium and fluorine atoms share one bond to form the compound sodium fluoride. Now, the valency of sodium and fluorine is 1 because they share one bond to form sodium fluoride. So, the concept regarding valency of an electrochemical bond gets clarified from the electronic configuration of an atom. Atom forms chemical bonds by using electrons of its outermost shell. In this you can see sodium given one electron to chlorine and they form a bond. Valency of an atom is determined by configuration of its outermost shell. Now over here, in sodium, the outermost shell has one electron and that shell is called as the valence shell. So if we go according to the name KLM, M is the valence shell of sodium atom. And it has one electron in that shell, so sodium has one valence electron. So outermost shell is called valence shell and the electron in outermost shell is called as the valence electron. And we can see that valency of an atom is related to the number of valence electrons in that atom. Now, let us take a look at the helium atom. Helium atom contains two electrons and it has only one shell. Since the capacity of K shell is two electrons, both of the electrons of helium are accommodated in K shell. Now, this indicates that the outermost shell of helium is completely filled and this condition is called as an electron duplet. Now let us look at the neon atom. The neon atom has 10 electrons and these atoms are filled in shell K and L. K shell has 2 electrons in it and the remaining 8 electrons are fitted in L shell. Since the electron capacity of L is 8, the outer shell, that is the valence shell of neon, is completely filled. Now this condition is called as an electron octet because 8 electrons are completely filled in the outermost shell, that is the valence shell. Now let us take a look at the argon atom. Argon atom has 18 electrons. The first 2 electrons are fitted in the K shell. Then, since the capacity of L shell is 8, the remaining 8 are fitted in L shell and then we have 8 other electrons remaining which are fitted in M shell. So the electronic configuration of argon is 288, and the M shell has the capacity of 18 electrons. However, only 8 electrons are fitted in M shell. This means that there are 8 electrons in the outermost shell, and this is also an electron octet, since 8 electrons are fitted in the valence shell. Now, helium, neon and argon are inert gases, that is, they do not combine with any other atom, and hence their valency is zero. And from this, we understand that valency is zero when electron octet or duplet is completely filled. Since except inert gases, the electron duplet or octet is incomplete, that means all other atoms except for the inert gases have tendency to combine with other atoms. Now let us take a look at hydrogen atom. It has only one electron in its valence shell, so it has an incomplete duplet. Now, to complete its duplet, it needs to combine with another atom whose valency is also one. So it shares another electron with another hydrogen atom and completes its duplet and forms a bond. Let us take a look at the sodium atom. Its electronic configuration is 281, that is, sodium has one electron in its outermost orbit. Now, the valency of sodium is also 1, as seen from the molecular formula NaCl and NaH. The electronic configuration of chlorine is 287. And it needs one electron to fulfill its octet. So they share one electron and form a bond, and this is how they form the compound NaCl. So you must be wondering, how do we calculate valency? So to calculate valency, you need to follow these steps. First, you need to know the electronic configuration of the atom. After that, you need to note down the number of valence electrons. If the number of valence electrons in the valence shell is less than 4 or equal to 4, the valency is equal to the number of valence electrons. Let us take a look at the example. We have beryllium atom over here, and beryllium atom has 4 electrons. The electronic configuration is 2,2. We know that we have 2 electrons in the valence shell, that is, we have 2 valence electrons. Since 2 is less than 4, the valency of beryllium is 2. Now, what if the number of valence electrons is greater than 4? In this case, you need to minus the number of valence electrons from 8. So, let us take a look at the example chlorine. Chlorine has 17 electrons, so its electronic configuration is 2. 8 and 7. Valence electrons are 7, which are greater than 4. So the valency is 8 minus 4, that is 1. And this is how you calculate valency of any atom in the periodic table. Now children, the atomic number of an element is the fundamental property of an element and its chemical identity. But there are some elements in nature which have same atomic number but different mass number. That is, the atoms of same element having same number of protons but different number of neutrons in its nucleus. Now such atoms are called as isotopes. For example, carbon has three isotopes, namely C12, C13 and C14. The mass number of isotopes is written as 12C, 13C and 14C as shown. And over here you can see the various carbon isotopes. They have same number of protons but different number of neutrons. Uses of isotopes. Isotopes of some elements are radioactive and they are used in various fields. One such example is uranium-235, which is used in nuclear fission and production of electricity. This is an image of nuclear power plant which uses nuclear uranium-235 to generate heat and to run steam turbines and produce electricity. Another example is cobalt-60, which is used in medical treatments of fatal diseases like cancer. Some other uses of radioactive isotopes are iodine-131 is used in treatment of goiter, that is a disease of thyroid gland. Radioactive isotopes such as sodium-24 are used for detection of cracks in underground pipes. Radioactive isotopes are also used in food preservation from microbes, such as in this image, radioactive rays. They kill the bacteria on the food that is shown, that is strawberry, and it can be preserved for a long time. Radioactive isotopes such as C14 is used to determine the age of archaeological objects. We have studied in history about the ancient civilizations of India, like Harappan civilization. So in this, the objects that are found, they are tested using C14, and from this we come to know how old these objects are. In uses of isotopes, we have studied how uranium-235 is used in generation of electricity. Now, nuclear reactor is a machine that generates electricity on large scale. This is an image of a nuclear power plant. And this is what happens in nuclear power plant. So you have nuclear reaction taking place, and in this, water is converted into steam. This steam is used to rotate turbines. These turbines rotate to generate electricity, and this is how we get electricity from nuclear power plants. Now, let us take a look at the nuclear reaction that happens in a nuclear reactor. We know that uranium-235 is used as fuel in nuclear reactors. What happens is, slow speed neutrons are bombarded on uranium-235. Now, this uranium-235 undergoes fission, that is, it splits into two different elements, that is krypton-92 and barium-141, and with that it gives out more 2 to 3 neutrons as well as some amount amount of energy. In this GIF, you can see that a neutron is bombarded on uranium and it gives krypton and barium. In this GIF, you can see how a uranium chain reaction takes place. After fission of first uranium atom, the neutrons go and bombard other uranium atoms, and so on, the chain continues. This is called as a chain reaction. A huge amount of energy is released during a chain reaction, and if it is not controlled, it can lead to explosion. Now, to control chain reaction in nuclear reactor, some provisions are made. First, we can either decrease the speed of neutrons or decrease the number of neutrons. Now, provisions such as moderators and controllers are done. In moderator, graphite or heavy water is used for reducing the speed of neutrons. And controllers are used to reduce the number of neutrons by absorbing them. This is done by inserting rods of boron, cadmium and beryllium, which absorb the excess neutrons and prevent them from bombarding further uranium atoms and continuing the chain reaction. There are total 22 nuclear reactors in 8 places in India which are functioning. Apsara at Bhabha Atomic Research Center, that is BARC in Mumbai, is the first nuclear reactor in India which went critical on 4th August 1956. In India, we have large reserves of element thorium, that is thorium-232. Therefore, Indian scientists have developed a future plan for nuclear reactors based on production of isotope uranium-233 from thorium-232. So let us have a quick recap about today's session. First, we studied about the valence shell and the valence electron. That is, valence shell is the outermost orbit of an atom, and valence electrons is the electron in valence shell. Then we studied about zero valency state, that is, valency is zero when electron octet or duplet is complete in an atom. We also studied that atoms other than inert gases have non-zero valency since they have tendency to combine with other atoms. We also studied that some elements have same atomic number but different mass number, and such atoms are called as isotopes. We also learned that nuclear reactor generates electricity by using atomic energy, and how nuclear fission takes place, that is, on bombardment of slow speed neutrons on uranium-235, its nucleus undergoes fission to form krypton and barium, and it gives out 2 to 3 neutrons along with some energy. And we learnt about Apsara at BARC, the first nuclear reactor in India. Children, we are at the end of session, and I would like to end this session with some homework. I request you to calculate the valency of following elements: lithium, carbon, magnesium and oxygen. Thank you and have a good day.